Hello everyone, this is the video number 3 of chapter 3 revision physics. Okay, in this video we will see one exercise example that is very much tricky. Mostly students are doing mistakes in that example. Okay, so first we will see what is the information, what is the concepts are required to solve that example. Okay, so first concept, that is cell in series. Okay, cell in series connection. So suppose cells are in series connection like this. Okay, three cells are in series connection like this. Suppose this cell has EMF epsilon 1 and internal resistance R1. Suppose this cell 2 has EMF epsilon 2, internal resistance R2, and suppose this third cell has EMF epsilon 3 and resistance R3, then this cell combination has equivalent, this cell combination has equivalent EMF, epsilon will be is equals to epsilon 1 plus epsilon 2 plus epsilon 3. Okay, and this type of connection is called helping condition. This type of connection is called helping condition. Why it is called helping condition? Because EMF is added. EMF is added and equivalent EMF is more than each battery's EMF. And how we can identify helping condition? That one negative connection of battery is connected with another battery's positive terminal. See, negative positive, negative positive, again negative positive. So this type of connection, one battery is negative, if one battery is negative end is connected with another battery's positive end, then it is called helping condition. Now which is another condition? Another condition is opposing condition. And what is that opposing condition? Suppose two batteries are connected like this. Suppose two batteries are connected like this. See, plus, minus, minus, plus. Two negative terminals. Okay, or one battery's negative terminal is connected with another battery's negative terminal. Then this type of connection is called opposing condition. Okay, this type of connection is called opposing condition. Suppose this has EMF epsilon 1, resistance R1. This battery has EMF epsilon 2, resistance R2. Then equivalent EMF. Then this connection's equivalent EMF will be epsilon 1 minus epsilon 2. Okay, it will not add it, it will subtraction. Subtraction will be taken place here. Okay, so this is the opposing condition and this is the helping condition. So you should know how we can identify helping condition and opposing condition. If one battery is negative end is connected with another's positive, then it is helping condition. If both batteries negative or both batteries positive ends are connected, then it is the opposing connection. Okay, in helping condition EMF are added and here in opposing condition EMF are subtracted. Okay, in this connection what will be the equivalent resistance? Equivalent resistance is find out same as series connection. Okay, here cell are in series. So same way resistance will also in series connection. So equivalent resistance will be is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. And that same formula will be apply here. Here equivalent resistance will be R is equals to R1 plus R2. Okay, for resistance same concept is applied. But for EMF there are two types of condition, helping condition and opposing condition, that you should know. Okay, that you must know. This is very much important for one mark question, for MCQ and for tricky examples. Now another thing is that cells can be in two condition. Cell can be in two condition. One is discharging condition, another is charging condition. Okay, so first condition, cell in discharging condition. This this first condition, that is the cell in discharging condition. In this condition, cell is connected like this. Yes. This is the cell with EMF epsilon and with internal resistance R. Current is flowing from one electric device. Suppose electric device has resistance R, then this is the called discharging condition of the battery that you have learnt already. In this condition, the equation of terminal voltage, the equation of terminal voltage will be like this, V is equals to epsilon minus IR. This is the discharging condition. Okay. But once, if this battery is discharged completely, then we should charge it. Okay. For next use of battery, we should charge this battery. Then what will be in charging condition? See, this is important. I think you have not studied this topic, cell in charging condition. So see, cell in charging condition. Okay, so in cell in charging condition, same cell epsilon and R, in charging condition, this cell is connected with another cell. This cell is connected with another cell of some voltage. Suppose this battery has voltage V. Okay. And obviously here V will be very much greater than epsilon, EMF epsilon. Okay. This is the battery, it will charge this battery. This is the battery to be charged, and to charge this battery, we are taking help of this battery. Okay, so we can say that suppose this is battery 1, this is battery 2. So we can say that here battery 1 is charged by battery 2, then the potential of battery 2 will be very much higher than the EMF of battery 1. Okay. Now what will happen in charging condition? In charging condition, current will be flow from here, bigger battery. Okay, from higher potential battery, and this current will come into this battery from positive terminal to negative terminal. Okay, here see, in discharging condition, current is flowing from negative to positive terminal, but in charging condition, current is flowing from positive to negative terminal. Okay, so here this electrons will charge this battery. Okay, done. So this is the charging condition. And in this charging condition, suppose we want to find out the terminal voltage of this cell. Okay, suppose we want to find out the terminal voltage of this cell, then its formula is V is equals to epsilon plus IR. Then its formula is epsilon plus IR. Remember it carefully. Today we have learned two new concepts. First, cell in series, in that two conditions, helping and opposing condition. Also in this discussion we have seen two conditions of cell, that is discharging and charging. Discharging we have already learned in your main syllabus, that is the terminal voltage V is equals to epsilon minus IR, but in charging condition V is equals to epsilon plus IR. Okay. Now with the help of this theory, we will do one exercise example. Now what is that example? Exercise 3.11. Okay, exercise 3.11. In this example, we are given that there is battery of 8 volt EMF and 0.5 ohm internal resistance. Okay, there is one battery with EMF 8 volt and internal resistance 0.5. It is connected to a 120 storage battery, 120 DC storage battery with the resistance 15.5. Okay, so it is connected with storage battery of 120 volt DC supply. This is the storage battery, and it is connected with external resistance, that is 15.5. And we are asked to find out the terminal voltage of this cell. Okay, So we are asked to find out the terminal voltage of this battery, which is to be charged by this battery. So first we will draw the circuit. This circuit will be like this. This is the battery that is to be charged. So it's EMF 8 volt. Internal resistance, we can show internal resistance here also, at this side also, and at this side also, your choice. That is the 0.5 ohm. It is connected with another resistance, that is suppose 15.5 ohm, and whole thing is connected to another DC battery, okay, to charge this battery. So it is 120 volt. Okay, now we want to charge this battery. We want to charge this battery, then this connection will be like this. Okay, you can't draw negative terminal here and positive terminal here because we want to charge this 8 volt battery. This storage battery will be connected like this in opposing condition. In opposing condition, okay, plus minus. Now, from here, current will flow I. Same current I will flow from here. Okay, we want to find out the terminal voltage of this battery. Okay, of this cell. Now, what will be the equation of the terminal voltage of this cell? Then it will have equation V is equals to epsilon plus IR. Okay, it will have formula epsilon plus IR. So to find out terminal voltage, we should first have the value of I current. Okay, we should have the value of I current. So to find out current, we should have the total potential and total resistance. So see, what is the potential of this circuit? Potential of circuit or equivalent potential of this circuit. Equivalent potential of this circuit. Now see, there are two cells, so two voltages, both are connected in opposing condition. Okay, so we can say that due to opposing condition, now we can say that net potential or equivalent potential will be, we will subtract, okay, so 120 minus 8. Generally what you are doing 120 plus 8. Okay, you are doing 120 plus 8. Don't do it here. 120 minus 8 will be there. Why? Because these two batteries are in opposing condition. See, positive and positive are connected with each other. Same negative and negative are connected with each other. So equivalent EMF will be 112 volt. Same way, equivalent resistance. Okay, same way, equivalent resistance. So equivalent resistance. See, here there are two resistance, 15.5 ohm, 0.5 ohm. Again, both are in series connection. So equivalent resistance is 15.5 plus 0.5. So equivalent resistance is 16 ohm. So here we have obtained first equivalent resistance, equivalent voltage. Okay, now we will find out current flowing from this circuit. I is equals to equivalent potential upon equivalent resistance. Okay, according to Ohm's law, I is equals to V upon R. What is V? That is 112. What is equivalent resistance? That is 16. 16 into 7, 112. So current is 7 ampere. So current is 7 ampere. That will flow from this circuit. And finally, what is the terminal voltage of this battery? So terminal voltage will be V is equals to, see, that will be epsilon plus IR. There will be epsilon plus IR. Why? Due to charging. Okay, here this battery is charged up. This battery is charging. So there will not no epsilon minus IR. There will be epsilon plus IR. Value of epsilon is 8 volt. Plus I is 7 ampere into small r is 0.5. So answer is 11.5 volt. Okay. So final answer is 11.5 volt. So this is how you can do the exercise 3.11 example. Okay. Very important, very tricky example. Very most MP example and tricky example. Okay. For 3 marks. Okay. So this was the example number 3.11. Now we will see Kirchhoff's second rule. How you can apply Kirchhoff's second rule. Actually, you know what is junction, what is loop. Okay, I will not define you what is junction and what is loop. Actually, you also know how you can apply the Kirchhoff second rule, but I am again revising how to apply Kirchhoff second rule. Okay, so Kirchhoff second rule. Or that is also called Kirchhoff's loop rule. Okay, that is also called Kirchhoff's loop rule. Okay, how you will apply? See this. To apply it, you should know two rules. You should know two rules. First rule. Suppose one electric device is given of resistance R and current is flowing in this condition, in this direction. Then the charges which will here at condition number 1, it will have some higher energy. It will have some higher energy. Okay, suppose E1, its energy is E1, and suppose in this condition these charges have suppose energy E2, then we can say that the energy E1 will be greater than energy E2. Okay, so if current is flowing in this condition and if also we are going in this condition, then we can say that we are moving from higher energy to lower energy. We are moving from higher energy to lower energy, so we are moving towards lower energy. Okay, so we will put negative sign. Actually, you will understand in one example, but only remember that. Okay, that in this condition higher energy, in this condition lower energy. Then second thing. Suppose there is battery, positive terminal, negative terminal. Suppose we are moving in this direction. Okay, then we can say that for battery also, we are moving from higher energy to lower energy. Okay, if we are moving in this direction, then for battery we are moving from higher to lower energy. But if we are moving in opposite direction, then we are moving from lower to higher energy. Okay, and remember, for resistance, direction of current is important to apply Kirchhoff's second rule. But for battery, direction of current is not necessary; it is not important. Okay, now we will apply the Kirchhoff's second rule on one circuit. Suppose one circuit is given like this. Suppose this is the circuit and these are the end. From this end, any type of current can flow, and I am giving you the direction of current. Suppose in this direction, in this branch, I1 current is flowing in this direction, in this branch, I2 current is flowing in this direction, in this branch, I3 current is flowing in this direction, in this branch, I4, and in this branch, I5. Okay, this is the resistance R1. R2, R3, R4 and R5. This is battery of EMF Epsilon 1. This is battery of Epsilon 2. Then battery of Epsilon 3 EMF and battery of Epsilon 4 EMF. Okay. Now we want to apply the Kirchhoff's second rule here. Suppose we are starting from here at from point A. Okay, and we are moving here. So how you can apply? See, first you will see in which direction we are moving. Suppose in this direction we are moving. So first coming is resistance R. We are moving in the direction of current. See, we are moving in the direction of current. So first we will write minus I1 R1. We will only write potential or energy. This is the potential. Okay, that is the minus I1 R1. Then battery is coming. For battery we will not see direction of current. Just we will see we are moving from positive to negative. Then we are moving from higher to lower. And we are moving from higher to lower. Then we will place minus epsilon 1. Okay, for battery, if we are moving from positive to negative, then minus. But if we will move from negative to positive, then plus. So minus I1 R1, minus epsilon, then here. in this direction. Okay, we are moving in this direction. So after epsilon 1, we will have epsilon 2 beta. So in this case, we are moving from minus 2 plus 3. Minus 2 plus, then this battery will have EMF epsilon 2 plus. Why plus? Because we are moving from minus 2 plus. Then here comes the resistance. In resistance, you will see the direction of current. Okay. We are moving in this direction and current is moving in this direction. So we are moving in the opposing direction of current. So there will be positive plus I2R. Okay. Then here see, we are moving in this direction and current is also moving in this direction. So again minus I3R3. So for current, simply you should remember that if we are moving in the direction of current, then minus I1R1, okay, or minus IR, and if we are moving opposite to the direction of current, then plus IR. Okay. Now here also we are moving from negative to positive in battery. For battery, you will not see the direction of current. So negative to positive, so plus epsilon 3. Okay, then again resistance, we are moving in this direction, current is moving in this direction, so opposite direction, so plus I4R4. Okay, again battery negative to positive. Okay, so again plus epsilon 4. Okay, and again for resistance, we are moving in the direction of current, then minus I5R5 is equals to 0. This is how we can apply the Kirchhoff's second rule. Simply, you should remember that for resistance, we will see the direction of current. If we are moving in the direction of current, then we will place negative sign. If we are moving opposite to the direction of current, then we will place positive sign. For battery, don't see the direction of current, just take positive and negative terminal. If we are moving from positive to negative, then negative sign. If we are moving from negative to positive, then positive sign. Okay. So this is the Kirchhoff's second rule and application of it. Okay. Thank you very much.